Hello everyone. Spring for me is in the air. I know it isn't for everyone, but the sun is out, you know, kids are starting to play more outside and the days are longer. We had our daylight savings. I'm feeling springy in my, you know, super bright top. I didn't realize this would be this bright on camera, I guess, but regardless, it's fun. I like it. And the whole point of this video is because whenever spring comes around, I feel like it's a new beginning again. It's almost like, you know, in January with New Year's, it's like new beginnings. Anytime there's seasonal changes, it's new beginnings. And that goes for my planners as well. I feel like sometimes I kind of revamp my system and I update things or I change dashboards or I change my whole planner. Things of that nature just are fun for spring. Big time cleaning happens for me. One downside to spring that I'm going to share with you guys that I absolutely hate is the mud. And Hank. Oh my gosh, it drives me bananas. And it drives my husband bananas because every time I let Hank in and out of the house, I'm like, oh, I hate spring. I hate it. He, I swear to God, like takes his paws and just is like, this feels so good. I love mud. Nacho, my little guy, hates mud. So I have no problem with him. He steers clear. Like he lifts his little legs up. He's like, I don't like mud. Hankle Biscuits, he loves it. He goes out there and he's like slides in it. And you know, he's a German Shepherd, so he's got like the longer hairs on his undercarriage as well as like the backs of his legs. So all that mud clings to him like crazy. And I don't have a mud room. It's basically like our back door opens into our family room. And same thing like with our garage. Everything kind of opens up into our family room. There's no mud room. So it's literally like this patch of just mud. It drives me nuts. I mop and clean several times a day because it just drives me bananas. Regardless of my issues with spring, I do love it. And I thought in this video, what I would do is just give you an update of what's going on with my planners and binders and things of that nature. I will definitely start doing more process videos since you guys really enjoy them. I will do them. They're fairly easy to film because it's just me doing my thing. And I just thought I would kind of, you know, let you guys know where I'm at with planners and my thought process when I'm selecting planners. So first planner I'll bring up is the Kiki K one. I have a full review of this and I will put a link for you guys so that if you do want to see the full review and the unboxing of this. I love this thing. I think it's so pretty. And what I currently use it for is the 43 folder system. So Alexis, or aka Miss Trenchcoat, if you guys watch her on YouTube, I think she's great. I really find her very inspiring. I think she is a young woman that's going places, and that's always so inspiring to watch that, watch someone do that. And she really kind of broke down the whole idea from the book Getting Things Done to create this, you know, folder storage kind of system. And it's basically, I don't want all these papers to fall out, but you basically kind of develop, I'll have that video linked for you guys so you guys can see it, but it's for every month to kind of keep you organized with all these like loose papers and things. It really just helps me stay organized and not lose papers, because things get kind of tossed on my desk and then get misplaced. Instead they get tossed in here and then they get filed and they are, more attention is paid to them and things don't kind of fall through the cracks. So that's what I use this beautiful binder for. It's a great idea if you guys are concerned, you know, you have tons of these binders, because I'm sure you're all like me and you like purchasing different binders. Using them for storage and things like that, you know, gives them another purpose, I guess, and it makes you feel a little less bad instead of it just sitting empty on a shelf. So I really like using that, this binder for that. I then have my domino that you guys have seen in a few videos if you've watched them, where I took apart my Erin Condren and I put it in here, and then I also just use it as my daily planner. I am currently using it just to house my things from my planner that are YouTube related. So any ideas that I've worked out, you know, the way that I haven't shown you guys like my process of how I do YouTube videos and how I schedule them out and how I put them out. But basically what I do is I have a week on two pages and I use post-it notes with any video ideas or blog posts that I want to do. And I kind of put them out on the weeks, and then things that I mention in videos or links that I need to put in, I always put them into the slots for that day that I'm posting the video. So all those pages kind of get archived in here for now, and it's mainly just the YouTube things, and they all kind of get archived in this binder. Then have my Franklin Covey. I purchased this on eBay used. This is, I believe, from the 90s. I love this thing. It's in the classic size. Zipper, by the way, that's what you just heard. It goes so smoothly in this bad boy. And I recently showed you guys my process video of how I decorate, like, for the week and for the daily pages. So just to kind of give you an idea, I'll also have that video linked for you guys if you're interested in seeing that. I have all of my daily pages in here. And this is just for, I don't know, it's for me personally, I like to really break down my days. I really like knowing where my time is going, what I'm doing with my time. It also helps me to break down things that I need for YouTube and social media and things of that nature. There's so many different avenues that you can take and do things, and I don't want to miss anything. So I really like to break down, you know, making sure I spend time on Facebook, on my Facebook page, on Instagram, that I remember to post photos, that I remember to comment back to you guys, that I remember to check my social media kind of Gmail, where I'm getting comments from all of you, I get emails from all of you. I'm also managing people who send me letters and packages and things of that nature. All of those things need to get addressed, and I don't want anything to kind of fall through the cracks. So I really like to break all that down during the day. I love breaking down all of my chores in the house. I think that, you know, it was a learning experience for me where I really had to learn how to manage the whole house, manage a small child, and kind of get everything done and feel accomplished as well as feel happy at the same time. So what I ended up doing was finding all these different lists on Pinterest that helped me break down kind of cleaning schedules so that I focus on different things for different days, and that way the house stays pretty much all clean most of the time. You know, where I have days that I focus in the kitchen where I do deeper cleans, but then I do like my 20-minute cleanups all the time. You know, I do my 20-minute cleanup every time my daughter goes out for a nap so that everything's picked up, all of her toys, all the dishes are put away, dishwasher's emptied, you know, ready to go for the next one. All of those types of routines and things, I like breaking them down in here. And anything that's archived from here, because I don't want it, you know, I have the one day on two pages. I don't know why that was so hard for me to say, but one day on two pages in here. This can get really, really bulky, even though the rings are really hefty sized in here. I think they're 2 inch in here. This guy, which is my also my other Franklin Covey that I have a video on, you know, why people are not using Franklin Coveys more, and this archives everything in here for me. So if I need to go back to anything that was from here, if I need to reference anything, it's all archived in this binder here. As far as archiving goes, I'll kind of touch base on this a little bit more in an upcoming video on how all of that goes, but I do like to keep things for about 5 or 6 years just because, I don't know, it's just my personal thing. I just like to keep things for about that long in case, just in case. You just never know what you need to reference, what you need to get, and they're like diary, you know, I mean, I don't know that I've ever really like thrown anything away. They just kind of get stashed into like bins and put away either in the crawl space in the basement, but these like archived ones stay in my office. So I'll touch base on that in a future video. Next binder, I love this. I also purchased this on eBay. I highly recommend going and getting your Franklin Coveys on eBay. I just think that you can get a lot of great binders out there that may need a second home. I've been going to thrift stores like crazy, you guys. I go to Goodwill, I've gone to the Salvation Army. I don't know, I wish I could find binders there. You guys seem to find all these great binders there. I don't know if mine gets scoured, like nobody uses binders around here or everyone just picks them up. I can't seem to find any at the thrift stores, but I think that's a great idea too. I just haven't been fortunate enough to find any there. Also, what section do you look in at Goodwill? Like I've gone to like the books, I've gone to like the housewares and places like that, and I just can't seem to find them. So if you know a secret spot, let me know. This guy I found on eBay, very inexpensive. I love this. It's got the zip around. I love the zip arounds. I love how fat the rings are in this. I just absolutely love that. This I switch out with a couple of the other ones that I'll show you. If a binder for me is not in like a current use, it acts as something that is storing. And so then when I decide that I want to use this one again as my primary planner, I take the guts out of this one out and flip it into the one that I was using before and then start using this one. I like to rotate my planners just as much as I like to rotate my handbags and my shoes. I very rarely wear the same pair of shoes every day. I don't. I wear a different pair of shoes every single day pretty much just because I like to change things up. Handbags, depends. Sometimes I have a handbag the entire season. Sometimes I change my handbag out weekly. It all depends. And binders, to me, honestly, are the same thing. It's whatever I'm feeling and whatever makes me happy is what I use and how I change things out. I don't follow any system. It's just whatever I want to do. I go to my shelf and I pick out the binder I want, take out the guts, and put them back in. It's kind of the beauty of binder the 6-ring, 7-ring binder system is that you can take the guts out and just put them right back in. I also enjoy putting planners together. You know, I like doing the dashboards and I like doing all the different things that go in here. So it's really a very fun process for me. I don't have a problem with it. So as of right now, it's acting as a storage binder. I then have this guy here. This is Pippa. She was the, the newest addition. She was actually, Franklin Covey was kind enough to send me her, as well as another that was a giveaway, which was sent to the person who won the giveaway. I love her. I think she's so sleek and beautiful. But prior to Franklin Covey getting in touch with me to send me this, I had purchased another one from Franklin Covey, and I'll show you that in just a minute. But Pippa is just beautiful. I have a review on her that I'll show you guys in the video. I'll have a link for you guys. I just love her, and I've been using her ever since Franklin Covey had sent her to me. But like I said, I was overzealous and I shopped and I got another one. And this other one is actually inspired by Alexis again. I've been like on a kick watching her videos and things like that. And she has this in her all of her videos pretty much. And it's this little macaroon binder, also from Franklin Covey. And they were out of stock for a really long time with this guy. And when I saw it in her video, they were already gone. I hadn't seen it on the website. And so I saw it on the website recently and I was like, I don't need this, but I definitely want it because I think it's just a great piece to have in the collection. Honestly, I just think it's very sleek, very pretty. You know, and everyone, I think that we're all, when we watch YouTube videos, I love people who like love their style. And I feel like Alexis and also like Corey from The Reset Girl, I love their style and they're like consistent with their style. You know, like they use either like the Kate Spade and they have like the black and the white with the gold. And I love that. I really do. I think it's very classy. It's something that I just enjoy watching, and so that's why I really liked this. You know, I'm feeling that like really classy kind of style. I really like it. I love colors and things too, don't get me wrong, but it's just what I'm feeling right now. And so seeing this, that it was back on sale, I had to go and pick it up. I think my only issue with this is definitely the only Franklin Covey that I've had where the rings are pretty small. But on the flip side of that, the good thing about that and the reason why I decided to use this one right now versus Pippa, so I'll show you Pippa next to Mac or Macaroon. Not that I named them, but it's just easier to say Mac and Pippa. So Pippa is here and this is Mac, and comparing them, just to show you guys, width-wise, approximately the same, except that Pippa's rings are a little bit bigger, so Pippa's a little bit fuller, more full-figured. And just to show you guys, as far as the elastic band goes, again, Pippa is definitely able to fit a bit more than Mac is. So Mac is a lot sleeker. And then here again is them from like the top view. And then to show you width-wise, here's where the significant difference is that Pippa is definitely wider than Mac. So Mac is on the slimmer side. I would say Mac is closer to like more of the Filofax and Pippa is a little bit wider. So I actually really love Pippa. I kind of prefer Pippa a little more than Mac. But the only problem with, I shouldn't say problem. The only reason why I decided to go with this one is because recently I have been out doing a lot more with my daughter. My daughter was pretty sick. We were on I'll just share a quick story. We were on vacation, we were out of the country, we came back and she got some really nasty bug. And so I was kind of in and out of the, not the hospital, but like the doctor's office, and doing a lot of things with her. I'm trying to get her into dance, so I had to go down there physically. I harass my poor real estate agent like all the time to see houses. Okay. You guys have to tell me this. Am I a total voyeur because I love looking inside of people's homes? Like, do I have a problem? I mean, I do it legally, you know, like I go in with a real estate agent, so I don't like go into someone's window and like peek at them. Although I would if their blinds weren't shut and I was walking by, I would totally look inside. But I love calling up my real estate agent and being like, hey, can we go take a look at this house because it looks really cool. And he does, like he goes with me. So he's so nice, he really is, for dealing with me. And my husband thinks it's so bizarre and why I'm so obsessed with looking at people. I don't know what it is, I don't know why. Like I like getting ideas and I just like seeing how people live their lives. Like I feel I could have been a really good therapist because I love to know how people live their lives. Like I love listening. I think I'm a pretty good listener. I love listening to people's stories and I love to hear how people live their lives. I just love it. So it's just, I don't know, is that a problem? Like if someone had an open house down the block here with the neighbors, I would totally go just to see what it looks like, right? Am I the only one that does that? Anyway, totally moot point. But what I was trying to get at was that I've been doing a lot of out of the house. And I feel like now my daughter is getting to the point where she's like toddler busy, that we are going more places and doing more things. And to be honest with you, I had Pippa with me. And Pippa's a great size. It's just that Pippa's a bit heavier than Mac. Mac's definitely slimmer. Pippa's a bit heavier. Not that big of a deal because I have a really big purse. I don't want to knock Pippa. I love Pippa. But Mac, I was forced to, because the rings are so much smaller, I was forced to really streamline Mac, like really, really streamline. I mean, very thin. This is the thinnest I had a binder in a very long time. And when I was at the doctor's office, this was so easy just to bust out and, get my like appointments in here. It was, I totally stole this idea with the Target card, as a dashboard. But what it forced me to do is really streamline things. So things are very neat. They're very slim in here. I don't have extra bulk in here. So I do have like a full year's worth of calendars as far as March goes. If you guys want like a full tutorial of how I kind of slim this down, let me know and I will definitely flip you around and show it to you. And then what I did and what I thought was a great idea was to really streamline my weeks. So my weeks are actually 2 weeks on a page, and that's really helped because then I only need 2 pages really for the whole month, you know, because there's 4 weeks. So it really has streamlined it for me. I was even able to fit my YouTube and kind of blog posts in here just by really keeping it streamlined and only keeping about a month or two's worth of weeks. So this is just kind of a sneak peek of how I do my YouTube stuff. And I have them on post-its because I relocate things and do things all kind of different. And then I also have a section for projects. I made this insert in here. I like using kind of the project management style whenever I'm working on projects in the house. But this really forces me to stay on the slim line, and it just works really well for the more out and about for me right now. Will that change? Yeah, it'll probably change in like 2 days. I'll probably be back in Pip on 2 days because I'll get annoyed with how slim Mac is. I don't know. That's so fun, you guys. But everything fits nicely. Like, I can take Mac and put him back into Pippa. I can take out Pippa and put it back into Mac for whatever I'm feeling that day. It's just, it just changes all the time for me. The only thing is that Mac really helped me to slim down a lot. Also, this pen is really slim, and I absolutely love this. This is from Happy Scrappy's planner kit, and I think she sells these on her site also. Look how thin this tip is. I love it. It's perfect for planning on the go. I just love it. But this just, I don't know, being slimmer and sleeker, it just worked really well for me in the doctor's office. Not that Pippa wouldn't or any of the others. These bigger guys, I love these. I absolutely love these. And if I was going into my office, you know, when I worked in the corporate world, if I was working in my office, I would totally lug this guy around, not a problem. Because it would work for me in that case. But with a toddler, I mean, I carry so much crap with her, you know, with snacks, my first aid kit for her, like all that kind of stuff. that this is very cumbersome to carry around, and it's not necessarily necessary. It's more of just my desktop, you know, where I really truly break down the day, break down ideas, break things down like that. That's what this is for. This is really just mainly for portability. It's so light, it's so small, so it's just kind of my one that I've selected. But you know, I love this one too because it zips. So if I get annoyed that stuff starts slipping out of here, I'll go back into this one. And this one, I love the ring size. I love how chunky that is. I could stuff this with way a lot of stuff. So I'm doing this video to share with you guys that it's okay to change your mind with planners. And it's because I get a lot of emails from you guys that says, you know, I can't find planner piece. I keep buying different binders and planners. I keep doing this, I keep doing that. I think it's okay, especially if you're fully invested in this hobby of stationery and binders and things like that. I just think it's okay if you like to change them out. I don't think there's anything wrong, and I don't think you should feel guilty. I hate feeling guilty. I don't like feeling that way, and I think that it's okay. It's okay to change things out when you're in a hobby, and that's just all I want to say. And it's okay to change something in order for it to work for you in this moment. You know, because I flip flop all the time, and the guts pretty much always stay the same. I mean, if I went from here to an A5, it's not that big of a deal because I have like A5 inserts, and I change binders and planners so often that I have inserts, you know, here in the A5. And these A5, if I decided I wanted to go back into my domino, these can all get flip-flopped around. And the joy of making new inserts and things of that nature is just fun. I just enjoy the whole process. So I just wanted to say that because I tend to get a lot of comments and emails from people saying I feel really bad about this beautiful, you know, File Effects original, and I already want to change it to like the Kate Spade Wellesley or whatever the heck that one, that planner is called. So I don't think there's anything wrong with it. I think in order for you to find which planner works for you or what size works for you, you kind of have to use it. You know, I can't tell you you should use a personal size Mac, you know, because that's going to work for you. You have to figure that out on your own. And that's part of the journey and part of the process and part of the fun. That really is. And so I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I hope I didn't ramble too much, but I'm just so excited to talk to you guys today. And I was just excited to show you guys Mac because he, she, whatever, has really kind of come in handy the last few weeks for me. So thank you guys for watching, and I will see you guys again soon. Take care. Bye-bye.